Vector FM is a granular FM instrument with a unique modulation system controlled by a 2D particle simulation. In this video, we'll explore how to make sounds with Vector FM and how to use the particle simulation to control elements within the sound. This video assumes a basic knowledge of how FM synthesizers work, so if you're not familiar with FM synthesis, you may want to do a bit more research before continuing. On the left of the device is the 2D particle system. This displays particles that are used to affect elements of the sound. On the right-hand side of the device are additional controls and four tabs we'll use to adjust parameters of the instrument, as well as parameters that control the behavior of particles within the 2D simulation. At the moment, Vector FM is in MIDI mode, so it will be triggered by MIDI notes. When Vector FM is in MIDI mode and none of the four tabs are visible, you can access the ADSR envelope for the device. Let's click into the first of the four tabs. This is the Operators tab. Here we can define how many FM operators we're using and what their configurations are. For now, we'll leave only one operator enabled. The second tab contains the conventional parameters of an FM synthesizer, like the carrier and modulator waveforms. When only one operator is selected in the Operators tab, the carrier will modulate itself based on the ratio and index values set in the modulator section. When the index is set to 0, you can use Vector FM like a conventional subtractive synthesizer as well, using the included multimode filter. Let's go back to the Operators tab. When we only have one operator active, each new MIDI note corresponds to a new particle in the display, and the FM amount is controlled in the Audio Parameters tab, as we've seen. When two or more operators are selected, each additional MIDI note corresponds to a new operator. How these operators interact depends on the FM configuration. For example, in the initial configuration, the first note played will create a basic sine wave carrier. The second note played will then frequency modulate the first note. A third note will create a new sine wave carrier, and a fourth note will frequency modulate that second carrier, and so on. This relationship between each carrier and modulator is indicated by a line joining the corresponding particles in the 2D display. Each carrier is also circled. An in-depth explanation of each operator algorithm is beyond the scope of this video, but explore other configurations and pay attention to how each note interacts. For now, let's switch back to just a single operator and head over to the Audio Parameters tab. The five controls at the bottom of the Audio Parameters tab introduce us to the first controls unique to Vector FM, the particle attribute controls. These let us manipulate elements of the synthesizer using attributes of the particles within the 2D display. The first control represents the horizontal position of a particle within the display. Let's map this to affect panning. If I play a note, you'll notice that the note's panning corresponds to the particle's horizontal position within the display. The second parameter represents the vertical position of a particle within the display. Let's map this to control the index value. Now, when I play a note, you'll notice that the FM index of the note is affected by the particle's vertical position. If I play additional notes, you'll notice that each note creates its own particle within the display, and each of these particles applies independent modulation to that note. The third control uses a particle's distance from the center to affect elements of the sound. Let's set this to inversely affect the gain. Now, each note will get louder as it approaches the center of the display. The fourth control uses the speed at which a particle is moving to affect elements of the sound. Let's map this to affect the pitch of the carrier. When a control is mapped to the pitch of the carrier, you can set a scale that the pitches will be quantized to. Let's go with octave. These results are a bit extreme, so let's dial back the control to about halfway. The fifth control uses the mass of each particle to affect an element of the sound. At the moment, you'll notice that the mass of each particle, which is indicated by the particle's size, isn't really changing. We'll deal with that in a moment, but for now, let's map this to affect the waveform of the carrier at about 25%. Let's start to control the particles in the simulation. Over on the fourth tab, you can affect the mass of the particles. You can set each new particle to have a fixed mass, or have the mass of each new particle randomized. Let's set the fixed mass to about 50% and the random mass to the max. Now, every time I play a new note or notes, their mass will be randomized. Not only does this mass affect whatever parameter I've mapped it to, in this case the waveform of the carrier, but it also affects how the particles behave within the simulation. Let's head over to the third tab, where we can adjust some more particle behaviors. In the center of the display is a white square. This represents the attractor. Particles will be attracted to or repelled from the attractor based on the strength control. Particles also have charges, represented by the color of the particle, blue for positive, yellow for negative. You can set whether the attractor attracts both positive and negative particles, or only one or the other. You can also use the magnetism control to affect whether oppositely charged particles attract or repel one another. As you might have noticed, very small adjustments to any of these controls can have quite varied results, so start by applying small adjustments and noticing how the particles behave. Vector FM is quite a complex device, but the basic idea is that you have a simple FM synthesizer whose parameters can be modulated using a complex 2D particle simulation. There are many more controls we haven't discussed, but remember that you can use Live's InfoView to discover more about the controls in Vector FM. Click the toggle in the bottom left of Live's window to open the InfoView. Then hover over any parameter within Vector FM to learn more about that control. Also, be sure to explore some of the included Vector FM presets to get an idea of the range of sounds possible. Yeah.